should have won. 1924.
We won, sir.
We won, sir. 19-0. How many times has a Welsh team defeated New Zealand by a margin of 19 points?
None, sir. 1953.
Forget about 1953.
Didn't they cream us, sir?
I said, forget about 1953.
And then?
1966.
1966. 1966, boys. Over. Over. Where Bleddyn Morgan stepped into touch in 66.
But the ref said he was in.
Wasn't it the winning try, sir?
In the last seconds of play, sir.
The only game on that whole tour that New Zealand lost, sir.
Blot on the old record book, sir.
Bleddyn Morgan stepped into touch. I saw it. I was there in the commentary box.
Back to Edwards. Edwards going to the blind side. He's still going. Goodness me, this looks dangerous. Have your blast cover coming across. Edwards has it out to Llewellyn. Llewellyn taken by Thorne. But he's got it away on the inside, and the Welsh are going for the corner.
Jones, boys, was the name of the touch judge. Jones.
Get me, Winston. I can't tell me.
Jones.
Bleddyn Morgan stepped into touch in 1966. I did it for Wales.
Don't you come your Welsh malarkey with me, sunshine. Your own bloody touch judge told me that Bleddyn bloody Morgan stepped fair and square into touch. And what's more, he wrote it down in a death bloody bed confession.
We won that game fair and square.
Don't come that way with me, matey.
Sir.
Good afternoon. There's been a sensational revelation at Cardiff Arms Park this morning that a Welsh rugby official cheated to defeat the New Zealand All Blacks of a test win in 1966.
Cheated! You lost the game!
Which game?
The game!
The game?
Our game?
That game.
The game?
Gentlemen and ladies, after due deliberation and in consultation with the New Zealand Rugby Football Union, the Welsh Rugby Football Union has reached a final decision
regarding the controversy surrounding the 1966 Test match between Wales and New Zealand. The match will be replayed this year at Cardiff Arms Park.
The teams will remain as they were in 1966. Phil Bennett, Tanefi. Right wing, Bleddyn Morgan, Pontypridd. Centre three-quarter, David Llewellyn, Pontypridd.
A.B. Wiley, Canterbury. E.M. Murray, Auckland. P.G. Brown, Auckland. I.P. Kirkpatrick, Hufty Bury. W.K. Nathan, Auckland. J.B. Farquhar, Otago. J. McBain, Otago. F.X. O'Riordan, Hawkesbury. M. Trotter, Bay Auckland.
Number 8, Mervyn Davis, Swansea. Thank you.
They didn't say whether you still coach, Grandad.
Go to bed, will you?
What?
Go to bed.
But I'm not ready for bed.
Get yourself to bed.
I'm not a child. I do play for Wales, you know.
Night, ma'am. Night, Dad.
Nighty night.
Granddad.
So, Bleddyn will be coming home.
Don't you believe it? If he knows what's good for him.
Not once in 25 years, Bled. Not even to see your old hometown. I reckon that's strange, don't you?
My hometown will look just the same in 125 years. Nothing changes back there. Believe me.
What about friends, relations?
For Christ's sake, Nairie! I wanted a new life. That's why I left. I've got a new life. You and the boy. There's nothing to go back for.
Father, are you really F.X. O'Riordan and you All Black, Father?
Watch this.
Imagine. It's a penalty to New Zealand. Midway the 25 and halfway. Cardiff Arms Park. 60,000 Welshmen.
Frank O'Riordan places the ball. Pacing it back. One, two, three, four, five.
The crowd is hushed.
Coming in now. Wait for it. The crowd will tell you. Listen! It's a goal!
Oh, yes. Yes.
Potentially, Jim, you're on a winner. But you've got to ride it.
Yeah, they've only picked me for the reserves.
Jim, you've seen the polls. You dropped another 2 percentage points in popularity last week. You've got to get into the starting lineup. Now, don't go soft on me.
Barry, come on! You know what I started to drink? Well, they made me bloody captain. I wasn't cut out to be a captain. I was cut out.
The touch judge.
Oh, yes, Morgan.
I had nothing to do with the cheating. I had my eyes on the try line, right?
Mr. Morgan,
why won't you go back to Wales?
Personal reasons. I'm not going back.
That's right, Boyle. Don't you ever.
Bleddyn Morgan?
What the hell do you want?
I want the best for Wales, a night in Morgan.
Sir,
can we have a question?
Well,
you're
only
playing
for
me.
Are
you going back?
At the Welsh
Centre? Sir,
sir.
I go off. Nothing's changed.
Who's the elderly gentleman?
My mother.
Nairi. Come and meet Nairin. My uncle. Nairin, meet Nairi, my wife.
A relation of Bled's. Oh, how marvellous.
Delighted, Nairi.
Where on earth did you spring from?
Oh, that's a long story.
Yes, sir, which he won't bore you with.
Come and see our son. Die.
Die?
Yes, let's go inside and get that coat off you. Nairin. God, you must be sweltering.
Ma'am, he's very old.
And you're very rude.
I'm from a very old country, Di.
David!
We've had some good winners, yes, but nothing like you since. The honour of Wales is at stake, man.
Well, why don't they play the reserves?
The back reserve went north to England.
Well, bring him back down.
He went north. He crossed over. He forsook the game of the valleys and he had his palm crossed with silver.
Why? League, eh?
League. Yes, there's no going back for those who have supped with the devil, Bleddyn.
Aye, aye. I suppose forsaking the valleys of South Wales for the valleys of New Zealand is a minor misdemeanor by comparison. Mm.
You've got to come back, man. If you don't turn up for that game, it'll be some sort of admission that there was a complicity between the players and old Jones. If you don't come back, you'll be branding all of us, the whole of Wales, as cheats.
Wales, rugby. I don't care anymore, now.
For Wales, boy. Wales.
You don't understand, now. Wales means nothing. I don't even miss it. I'm sorry you wasted your time.
Les!
Now leave him be, love. Leave him be.
Him.
I thought he was dead.
The Lord watch over me.
Guide down on it, Black.
God, that's his hands. Hungry down there.
Reasonable.
McBain!
touch, Haggis. Down! On the ball now, you great big lumbering ox! Oh! Get down on the ball, Black! Dive on it! Support him, Black!
Anymore, Clary.
You great fat blow-up sheep.
That's right, I am. I've come to terms with my lack of aggression.
You what?
I'm a man of peace, Clary.
You were the dirtiest bastard in the team. You were the enforcer. Mad Murray, the monster of Cardiff.
You made me do it. It's not in my nature. I forgive you.
You bloody what?
And the Lord forgives you.
Hey, Austin! Austin, I need a drink.
There'll be no drinks here, not a bloody drop. You and I have got lots of time, Ewan. Now you know, and I know, oh man of peace, that deep within you there dwells a beast, a terrible beast, and I'm going to find him. And you know what I'm going to do with him when I find him?
He's not there. He's gone.
I'm gonna slip the bloody leash and let him run amok on some Welshmen.
You should have offered him money, bloody New Zealander.
There's still time.
Bloody! Oh, welcome home, boy. Oh, well done, Anidin. Mission accomplished.
Thank you. Oh, Bleddyn, this is the president of the Welsh Rugby Union, Evan Price.
Mr. Price.
No, Evan, please.
Evan. It's my wife, Nairi, and my boy, Di.
Well, this is war, man. No place for women and children.
Well, we may as well get back on the plane, then.
Oh, no, wait. Now, there is no reason at all why Nairi and your lovely boy should not have a wonderful holiday in Wales while you, Bleddyn, are in training camp. You're all at the Welsh Rugby Union's expense, of course. Excuse me, Anidin. I'm thinking of a certain village in the picturesque, revitalized valleys.
She can't come back to the village.
This is all for Wales, man.
Wales doesn't have to live in my village. I do.
Well, what are we going to do with them, then?
Yes, all right. But there will be a price to pay.
Spare no expense. Within reason.
I'm not talking about money.
Thank God for that.
You're very welcome to stay in my home, Nairi.
I'm not going back to the village. Now, I agree to come back to Wales, but not Abercannon.
Not you, but them. You are going to direct to Porth Call, where you'll be in strict training until the big game.
This is bloody lunacy.
Well, war is lunacy. Sacrifices have to be made.
Oh, we'll be fine, Blaise. We're far better off with Anirin than hanging around waiting for you to finish practice. We'll see you in Cardiff for the big game.
Right, now you two, you give us 5 minutes, right?
Sad farewells before embarkation. I haven't been this excited since Dunkirk.
We lost that one.
What about my kit? I have got no playing gear, man.
You'll find it all laid out for you in there. We're not doing things by halves, boy. I'll drop your suitcase at the hotel.
I warned up. Bloody! Oh, come
on, you like it? Bloody, you like it?
Sure,
you like it?
Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you like it? Sure, you
Scarlet, mate.
Where have you
been? Clifford, for God's sake. Hey, but you still look as old as you did 25 years ago, mate.
Aye, and you were just as cheeky. Enough of this, sentiment. Follow me.
Hey, Mike, how are you?
I've laid out your gaff for you, the same as always. Right next to your best mates.
David.
Well, I leave you two to it. Barry, you want that leg rub?
Back then.
Right then. Let's have you out on the park.
Come on, let's go.
This is not a social weekend.
So beautiful in Ireland. So quaint.
It's so old. Do people really live in these houses, Uncle in Ireland?
They live in them and they die in them. And in between times, they fight in them.
Where you been hiding?
New Zealand.
What? Hey, you're not a spy, are you?
Of course I am. But I can't make my mind up which side I'm spying for. Welsh, innit?
Slow down then.
Sorry, Acid. Sorry. Sorry!
Rupert, sharp!
I've had to put up with some hopeless bloody bastards down the years. But you lot must have been the worst. And you certainly haven't improved with age. You and Murray. Big fat bloody you. Big fat bloody sheep. Frank O'Riordan. Father Frank. Jesus, Mary, Patrick, and St. Joseph. Don't let me ever kick for touch again. With the line in sight, and our backs lined up begging for the ball. But with passes like yours, the more ball you bloody kick away, the better. Bastards. You! Fuck, wah. You political joke.
Now, hang on.
Shut up! The captain. The captain who'd spew up before every game. Ask him to call heads or tails, and he'd break into a cold sweat. The captain who lost lost the Welsh game.
They did cheat, you know, Acid.
What?
They cheated. Didn't they?
Of course the bloody Welsh cheated, Sonny. They cheated. We cheated. The referee cheated. The linesman cheated. The ball boys cheated. The place was full of husbands cheating on their wives and wives cheating on their husbands. Everybody was bloody cheating. But we bloody lost! The world's cheated. The world's bloody won. Because of you. And you. And you. Keep it tight, I said. You kept it about as tight as a ferret in a railway tunnel. The world's cheated. The world's bloody won. But they won't win again, will they? And do you know why they won't win again? Because I won't bloody let them! Now, I want to hear that back from you. From each and every one of you. The bloody Welsh won't bloody win because bloody Acid won't bloody let them! All right, say it.
The bloody Welsh won't bloody win because bloody Acid won't bloody let them.
Scream it bloody out!
The bloody Welsh won't bloody win because bloody Acid won't bloody let him!
That's better.
Ready?
Yeah, boys.
Let's see if the king still got it. I want a Gario in right on Bleddyn Morgan's nose.
Hold it on, boys.
Over the top! Over the top! Rock that ball!
I don't know what the hell's been going on since we last got together. But maybe you three had better enlighten us. Then God help us against the old blocks.
Come on, boys. Come on, let's get on. Come on.
Then, Iden, who's this other man? He seems to be in every photo with Blaise.
Oh, that's David. David Llewellyn.
Who's David Llewellyn?
Oh, he and Bleddyn grew up together. They were inseparable. They went to school together, they played together. And in 1966, they gave this village its finest moment when they were both selected to play for Wales against the All Blacks. We gave the coach as well. Can you imagine that? Three of our finest sons. And up until then, this village had only produced one full international in its history.
Bleddyn never even mentioned his name. Why?
You'll have to ask Bleddyn that.
And Nairn?
I'm sorry, love, but that's between Bleddyn and David.
Come on, get it!
Yesterday, upon the stair, I met a man who wasn't there. He's still not there and won't get far. I think his name is Jim Farquhar.
Helen! I'm doing my best.
Well, do it. Quicker.
What do you want me to do? Kill the blindside faker?
If necessary.
Would you like a carrot to nibble down?
Carrot? The boy needs something more substantial than a carrot. Oh, let's nip in here and get a couple of tins of baked beans. Oh, hello, Bronwyn.
A Nairin.
Oh, Bronwyn, this is Nairi. Nairi Morgan from New Zealand. And this is her son, Di. Oh, Nairi, this is Bronwyn Llewellyn, David Llewellyn's wife. Well, you remember the man in the photos.
David, Bled's old friend. Yes, pleased to meet you, Bronwyn.
Hello, Nairi. Hello, Di. Welcome to Wales.
Hey, boys! Boys! Surprise!
What the hell are you doing here?
Mr. Price brought me here.
A member of the current Welsh team to give you the benefit of his experience.
What experience? How to lose to the All Blacks by 50 bloody points?
Mr. Price, you said it was arranged.
It will be, boy, it will be. Strategy meeting, I think. In the war room.
My own bloody grandson? Come to teach us how to play the game? My players, Evan, can remember actually beating the All Blacks. This modern lot, they haven't come within 30 points of it.
It's a different game these days, man. Different plays. Different rules.
I don't want you to be here.
It wasn't my idea. Bleddyn Morgan. Mr. Morgan. Owen Llewellyn, Mr. Morgan.
Llewellyn?
Yes. You and Dad, you know the photos together back home in the village. Dad! Dad! I thought...
And how is your mum, Owen?
She's fine. Very well.
I will give her my regards, won't you?
Owen knows the moves, Roy. You can't go using the old Gary Owen ploy all day. The crowd won't stand for it.
The crowd? I don't give a monkey's what the crowd...
Listen! Rugby union is now part of the great entertainment industry and there's no getting away from it.
Yeah, the next thing they'll want is a touch of mascara to highlight the scrum half size.
Be reasonable, boy. The All Blacks will be au fait. Very au fait.
Piss off! Go on, get out, clear off! And take that bloody Dulux colour card with you!
Acid. He's only trying to help.
Off, off!
The man's clearly deranged under the pressure.
I've seen Christmas trees with less decorations. Modern rugby. Right!
Ewan.
All week.
really think I'd be able to go a week without a drink. But I've done it. We might just win.
Harry, football's just a game, and a child's game at that. It's a part of life. Accept that, and you'll accept yourself.
Boys, how lonely must the unbeliever feel, devoid of his God, living a life without meaning, without purpose? How lonely. How lonely.
Father. Father, would you hear my confession?
Of course.
Bless me, Father, for I've sinned. It's a long time since my last confession. In that time, I've sinned in so many ways that I wouldn't know where to start.
Start with the worst.
They say the worst sin is despair. And the worst despair is despair of God. I have despaired of God. I've despaired of God. When I saw him take away from me the greatest halfback that has walked this earth, taken away so that instead of showing God's symmetry to packed terraces, he could talk about it in half-empty churches. But now I see God's scheme. He has brought the halfback back to me. He's going to confirm the beliefs of one generation at the same time that he opens the eyes of a second. And I have seen God's plan. And I ask God's forgiveness.
Can't find Barry anywhere.
All right, smarty pants, you're replacing Barry Brown. Do hope Barry's all right. He's your mate, isn't he? Wouldn't want to see your peace disturbed.
Playing. Shit! It's the All Blacks.
See the Wild West show. Sorry I'm late, boys.
Oh, the skipper.
Yeah? Hmm? Well, I didn't reckon you much, mate.
Oh, Jesus.
Hey, why don't you change his nappy? He's already had it, eh?
Good. Let's do it again with the gas on, right?
Good. Turn it. Let's turn it right. Let's have it.
Come back.
Give him here.
Back or what? Back there.
Stay away from him.
Leave him alone. He's concussed.
Get back! Stay away from
him! Leave him alone!
Cool it.
Clifford! Go and get an ambulance. Now!
Sounds a bit quiet tonight. Gin and tonic, lemonade shandy, and my usual, please.
I'll bring it over, Bud.
What's that old jar doing up there?
Oh. All right, Phil?
Help yourself.
Now then. You look at that very closely. What do you see?
It looks like a piece off an oyster. Yuck.
Di, that is a historic relic. This village's first Welsh international was a man by the name of Robert Foster. Played for Wales in 1903. Oh, that's his picture up there. Oh, and that old ball, that's old Lucky. The ball that he kicked with such alacrity. And this, well, this is a piece of cartilage taken from the great man's knee and preserved for posterity. That's why they call the pub the Ball and Gristle. Oh, thanks, Phil. Oh, Phil, pass us down old Lucky.
Here you are.
Thanks. That's old Lucky. Wales never lost a match with old Lucky. And there's a custom here that visitors who kiss old Lucky will also be lucky. Nairi?
What's it made from?
This is your original pig's bladder. None of that synthetic nonsense.
No thanks, Anidan.
But is Lucky?
I'd prefer to take my chances.
Love.
God, it's good to be home. It's like a bloody nutters farm down there. And Dad, he's the worst of them.
What do you mean?
I was running these moves, and the first one we did with the gas on, Bleddyn Morgan collided with Phil Bennett and was concussed. Ma'am, it was deliberate.
Phil Bennett, you said?
Yes. But it was set up by my dad.
What did you think about Welsh? Something else. Owen. Yes.
You go in, love.
Go on. Well, half, isn't it? Bron. Bleddyn. Bronnie. Is that really you?
Come to see you, Bled. With your wife, Nairi. She is here too.
My love.
Can you be okay, love? Got a whack on the head at practice.
I remember David coming across.
Bled, listen. Bronwyn's got something to tell you. You and she have got lots to talk about. I now stay here in Cardiff till we hear from you. See you later.
No.
He's only doing what he thinks is best for the team.
He turned me into something I'm not.
When our Lord drove the moneylenders from the temple, was he something he wasn't? There's such a thing as righteous anger, Ewan.
We're both men of God, Frank.
Yet we spend so much of our lives denying things. I think God wants us to celebrate things. And this game will be a celebration.
What Clary Atkin turned me into out on that field was no celebration, Frank.
The whole world will be watching that game. Without you, it won't be a game, a joke.
I'm going in. Look, whatever demons are inside us, we have to stay and face them, not run away. Besides, if you don't go, I'd blame myself.
Incredible scenes here at Auckland International Airport as the Governor General, the Prime Minister, and thousands of ordinary New Zealanders farewell the 1966 All Blacks as they set off on their appointment with destiny.
Ah, oh, Murray, bloody lunatic. You lost all control.
Does that mean they'll drop it?
Helen, the only way I'm going to get out onto that grounded cart is if someone pours a crate of scotch down Barry Brown's throat the night before the match.
Jim Farquhar. You must have been disappointed at not being in the starting lineup, still one of the reserves.
Look, I'm a team man. Whatever the team wants, it's fine with me. When you've been in politics as long as
I... Don't talk to them, you dumb galah. No bloody comment. Understand? Comprendo? Parlez-vous? Okay, let's go.
Mr. Eric Hogg. Mr. Hogg.
No comment. Come on.
Let me take that.
How are you feeling?
Oh, better. Much better. Listen, I'm sorry. My father, he's not normally... It can't have been easy for him, boy. Owen, I had no idea I had a grown-up son.
Yes, I know.
Ah, here we are.
Well, and Irene will be waiting for you. So I'll see you tomorrow. Ah. Goodbye.
Bye, Bronnie.
See you tomorrow then, Bleddyn.
Bye, boy. Bye, Owen. Owen. I know we can't undo what's been done, but it still gives me pleasure, boy, to see the way you've turned out. It really does.
are, sir. The Paul and Gristle pub.
There's nobody about. Go for it, boy.
My dad.
Well, it could have been him. Or it might have been him. They all look much older. But they're still the old blacks.
Boys, save your vital fluids. Beware of the wily Welsh, and especially of the wily Welsh women.
I know it's not going to change anything. They won't undo what's been done. But I just want to know. Well, I've always wanted to know. Why did you leave me?
You said you never wanted to see me again.
No, I didn't.
I would have never gone away if Lloyd hadn't said.
Dad?
He came to me. The morning after the match, the morning after we...
You believed him.
You were engaged to my best friend. I betrayed the both of you. Of course I bloody believed him.
You knew I loved you.
I thought you did die. But when Lloyd said you didn't, I couldn't come back. Could I? Hey?
Jesus, what a bloody waste.
Go back to your own life, Bleddyn, and leave me with mine. Go with love. Wheels expects.
Five years ago, I caught you on the piss just before a big game. I let you run out on that field and we lost to the Welsh. Don't let me down again, son. Remember, it's the first drink that does the damage.
You've met Helen, haven't you?
Come on, we're just in time.
And as they wander down the track, turns my heart to stone that I am a New Zealander and therefore man alone.
Well, at least God's not a Welshman, Frank. He wouldn't have built such ugly chapels.
Hey, you and Frank, quick, it's Barry.
Yellow
Elephant, the kangaroo. Never mind the weather, as long as we're together. We're off to see the Wild West show. All those for a drink, then, boss.
Not for me, thanks, Barry.
Barry. I wash my bloody hands of you, son.
Well, it's up to you, Lloyd. Whether I play or not, just as you like.
Well, you better take your place then, hadn't you?
Hello, boys.
Hello, good to see you,
I've talked to Bronwyn. David.
She had no right.
She's his mother.
Bloody stay away from him.
You're his father, David. Right, not boys. Me. You brought him up. What's wrong with him?
Now then. Scrum, okay, over by Clifford.
Come on, boys.
Come on. Barry?
Yeah.
Want the big one?
Yeah, okay.
The ball and gristle.
Okay.
What's the move, Div? David, what's the move? Now, come on, you don't want to cock it up in front of all the press, do you? Look, I'm not going to go in there and take him away from you. The boy won't have that anyway.
You and me. Double dummy scissors. And Benny goes wide.
Thank you.
By God, they're ready.
Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon and welcome on behalf of Welsh Rugby Union to the National Stadium, Cardiff Arms Park, for today's special international match between Wales and New Zealand.
Hold out your hands!
join hands. I'm with you, boys.
What do we ever do together, Blim? Try to set you up again like I used to? So you can run in try after try and get all the glory? Think I should do that for you again? Make you look good?
Monsieur,
monsieur,
allez, oh là là, mais qu'est-ce
que c'est? Voyons.
Bon, écoute-moi, hein.
Moi, je suis un dur, hein. Et si vous commencez quelque chose, n'importe quoi, méfiez-vous, hein, je vous sors, mais tout de suite, hein. Vous m'entendez? Bon, premièrement, je ne veux pas de stouch, hein, pas de tirage des couilles. Ne vous crevez pas les yeux, parce que vous, hein, vous, je vous connais. Oh là là, oui. Je ne veux pas de ça. Vous m'entendez? D'accord, oui.
Is there an appropriate response, do you think?
We could try, oui.
Oui.
Oui?
Oui.
Eh bien, oui. Allez, on s'y va.
Wide out between Llewellyn and Morgan is as good as ever.
Damn it!
It's tight.
for?
4 points for the try these days. Phil Bennett with the conversion. Yes! 6-0! There's a lot of feeling down there. Wales are on top in the early stages. There's big Alan Martin, the line-out expert, and he's palmed it to Graham Price. He's charged with the rest of the Welsh pack to midfield. Can they clear it for number nine, Gareth Edwards? Yes, Edwards changes direction. Oh, there's Gerald Davis. A lovely break by Gerald Davis. Out to the weather, number 13, heading for the corner, but he's thrown down. The move dies. Bleddyn Morgan was waiting in the clear on the wing, and a certain try's gone begging.
That was Bleddyn bit them.
I know.
Right on half-time, still 12 points to nil. Wales have played a brilliant first 40 minutes. The put-in here from Gareth Edwards again. Coming off the back of the scrum is Mervyn Davis. To Edwards to John, it's his turn to run.
Size of a pea.
For the piss and wind.
Possession, all right? Possession.
What the bloody has went on out there? You've eaten two tries between you.
Ask him.
What the hell do you think you're playing it, man? I've seen better passes than that from a smelly miner that never turns ball.
Take it easy, man. Take it easy.
Well, bloody sort things out. Because you two have got the winning of it or the losing of it in your own hands.
Give it away, I said.
Give it away. That's the new All Black motto, is it?
Acid. Last week I thought, maybe. We're a clapped out joke, Acid.
Will you take the bloody cake? Franco Reardon, the wonder boy of Napier Marist. So that's the sort of thing you were saying behind my back, is it, when you crapped out in 66?
Clary, you really got to understand. It's not 1966. And it's never going to be 1966 again.
It bloody is 1966 for the bloody Welsh, and that's why they're winning!
It's far too late, Acid. If we were ever going to beat them, it was 25 years ago.
Acid, all we can do now is try and keep the score down.
sword. Just a bunch of sad old buggers sitting round waiting for your pensions. And you can open your rugby almanacs and take your grandchildren on your knee and show them how in the replayed match between the Welsh and the All Blacks suffered an all-time record hiding. I'm happy to wash my hands of the whole bloody lot of you.
Listen. I'm as old as the hills. Death breathes at my door. But I will fight to my dying day any and every obstacle that ever steps across my path. Because that's how I've squared up to life. And I want nothing to do with those who would lie down and accept the worst death of all. The scorn of generations to come.
Come here, boy. Yes, you, come here. What's your name, son?
Glendower, sir.
Glendower? Glendower. Well, Glendower, Wales expects.
Sir?
This, Glendower, is Old Lucky. Wales never lost a game with Old Lucky. And while things seem to be progressing according to plan at present, Old Lucky is our insurance that Wales will not be upset.
Sir?
If Wales is in trouble, if catastrophe threatens, you must get this ball into play. Must. You understand?
This ball, sir.
If peril threatens, Glendower, you will be the savior of Wales.
Is Owen such a burden that I've got to be condemned for the rest of my life?
He's been the light of my life.
Well, then, what's the matter with you?
You betrayed us.
It's been 25 years.
You just walked away. You spoiled her. You spoiled us. You left her wondering. 25 years of wondering. What if? What if? Well, I've had 25 years of trying to fight a phantom. You could have stayed when I fought for her. A fair fight. She'd have seen you for real. Me for real. I'd have stood a chance. I could have won. But no, you just walked.
I loved her as much as you did.
Then why did you walk?
Come here. Tell him. Tell him, Lloyd, why I left. Come on, Lloyd. How much do you want Wales to win? Spill the beans. Tell the truth for Wales. Come on, Lloyd. Or this game is lost.
I told him Bronwyn was sick in her heart about what had happened, that she didn't love him, and she never wanted to see him again. I was trying to do my best for both of you.
Oh. Right, lads, second half, and give it guts.
It's all yours, Clippers. Come on.
The Welsh pack drive forward. They're working really well. See how
no good.
Oh, dear, did I just see you and Murray punch Jim Bagwell? I think I did.
Where's the camera?
Where the blaze is the hang you again?
Oh,
and it's Barry Brown, the sacked all-black skipper, coming onto the field, number 16, going into the line-out, and the game restarts with a deep ball to Wiley. Wiley gives it to McBain, number one. And this is the best all-black forward rush so far. Down they go towards the 22. It's coming for a red out to third, but surely those Welsh backs are offside. And the referee agrees we should appeal towards the penalty. A red and with the kick. We'll be right back.
due deliberation.
And in consultation with the New Zealand Rugby Football Union.
The Welsh Rugby Football Union has reached a final decision regarding the controversy surrounding the replayed 1966 international between New Zealand and Wales. The match will have to be replayed.